I'm Ahmad from Iraq. So a while ago I did a video about bringing still images to life and make them move. I used Photoshop and Premiere Pro. So in this video I'm going to show you how I did it. So without further ado, let's get started. So first off, what we need to do is subtract some things in this image in order to make them move. By subtracting them, I mean making them as a standalone layer. So first, I'm going to start with a bullet. I'm going to select it using the magnetic lasso tool. Just making a simple selection around the bullet to subtract it from the background. And then I'm going to right-click and click Layer via Cut, which will do the job of making the bullet as an independent layer. As you can see, it's now a separate layer called Layer 1, which contains the bullet. But the problem is that what's behind the bullet is just a white color, which wouldn't help us if we want to change the position of the bullet. So to fix this, hold Control on your keyboard and click on the layer to select it. And then click on the background, go to Select, Modify, Expand. I'm going to expand the selection by 3 pixels. Then when it's expanded, hit the Delete key to bring the fill window. We're going to use Content Aware. Make sure it's the one selected, then click OK. Now just to make sure, we're going to check and see if the Content Aware filling did a good job. And it didn't. So we're going to try to manually fix the problem using the Content Aware healing tool. Okay, so that's better. So as you can see, we completely separated the bullet from the background. Now I'm going to use the exact same technique to the holes made by the bullet and the scattered small pieces of the apple. So I'm going to speed the selection process. Okay, again, right-click and click Layer via Cut. And again, hold the Control key and select the separated layer. The same process of going to Select, Modify, Expand, just to make sure we're surrounding the entire thing. And this time, I'm going to expand it by 5 pixels to fix it well with the Content Aware fill. And again, click on the background and hit the Delete key. So we separated the second thing as a separated layer. Now I'm going through the exact same process, so I'm going to speed it up. Alright, so we're done making separated layers. Now it's time to save each and every individual layer as a standalone image, so we can use it in Premiere Pro. First, we're going to save the background. We're going to hide other layers and saving only the background as a JPEG image. Now the same thing to the other layers. But this time, other layers have to be transparent. So because the BNG file type allows such thing to happen, we're going to save it as a PNG file type. So I'm simply hiding the other layers and saving the one I want to save, because I don't want other layers to appear when saving a certain layer. And finally, the bullet. Now we're going to move over to Premiere Pro. Okay, so now we're in Premiere Pro CC 2014. After creating a sequence and importing the images that I just saved, I'm going to drag them one by one on top of each other into the sequence, starting with the background. I'm just going to shorten the duration just a little bit. And then I'm going to drag the rest of the images into the sequence. So because we didn't move the layers from Photoshop and we kept them at their exact location, notice they are fitting right into their place here. So I'm just expanding my view here. Now in the Effects Control tab, click on the Motion Effect arrow to the left. And as you can see, we have to create a keyframe in order to give us a starting point in terms of motion. So it starts in this exact position. And then I'm going to move to the end of the clip to create another keyframe, which will be at the end of the motion. Or how will a motion look like at the end? And then I'm going to move the bullet from its position just a little bit. Make sure that you have the end keyframe selected, otherwise you'd be creating another keyframe. So if you move the video, notice how the bullet is moving. Now we're going to use the same technique to the first scattering in the apple by selecting it from the sequence. And again, creating a starting and an ending keyframe. But this time, it's going to be a scale keyframe and a position keyframe, because we're going to change its scale and position as well. I'm trying to get a good result that looks a bit realistic. As you probably can see, it's all about keyframes. So I'm moving to the final keyframing process here, so not to waste time, it's the same process, so I'm going to speed it up. So that's it. As you can see, the entire image just went from a still image to a moving slow motion video. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.